Hunza, Pakistan has one of the most beautiful landscapes in the entire world, breathtaking views I can only describe as heavenly. If possible, your trip to Pakistan needs to include a day, or many, in the Hunza Valley. In this video, I will give you details on things to do and food to eat in one ultimate day in the Hunza Valley. Gilgit-Baltistan, called GB, is the northernmost province in Pakistan.
It is home to Hunza, some of the most amazing scenery on the entire earth, and a day spent there is like a day from a dream, so let's get started. Here are your 9 things to do to make the most of your day
in the Hunza Valley. Morning, 6 a.m. Rakaposhi Mountain View at sunrise. On a clear day, look south from Karimabad town. The sun's rays will be coming from your left, and see the towering white form of Rakaposhi looking down on the entire Hunza Valley. 7 a.m. in the morning. Eat Gyal, a local Hunza breakfast. Gyal is a traditional local breakfast food, wheat pan-fried cakes with honey or fruit jam and the local favorite ingredient, apricot oil. There are several different types of gyal, and the thing I love about this dish is how it is so simple and hearty, the perfect combination for a morning cup of buttery hot milk tea. Local oats, muesli. Honestly, this is one of the tastiest breakfast foods ever, and I am not entirely sure I can name all the parts. Almonds, walnuts, brown flaxseed and apricot seeds all roasted perfectly and then ground. Tea sprinkled over a combination of barley and a local species of wheat germ. It is heavenly when topped off with a scoop of fresh locally made cream or yogurt and a spoonful of honey. Do you may have other options? We stayed at the Serena Hotel, where the breakfast options included all of these dishes and more. If you aren't staying at a hotel, then the Karimabad market is the most likely place to find the dishes mentioned above. If you do visit this market, also worth trying our mantu or mantu.
It's a Chinese style meat filled wheat dumpling. 9 a.m. in the morning.
Climb to Baltit Fort. Baltit Fort is a beautiful landmark of the town of Karimabad, the largest town in the Hunza Valley.
Once the ruling seat of the Hunza kingdom, it has been standing overlooking the valley for over 700 years. It also means that this is one of the best places for an entire view of both Karimabad and
Hunza Valley. The climb up may be strenuous for some. Remember to take time to allow your body to acclimatize to the Hunza Valley's high elevation. The short but steep ascent is worth it, though the views here are stunning. You are also in the perfect place to enjoy a few snacks on the way down, an immediate reward for your morning exercise.
Increase your lifespan with Hunza water. Expensive bottles of mineral water can't compare to the life-giving benefits in the water that Hunza residents drink for free. Some of the longest living people on planet Earth, scientists have named
his glacial drinking water is the number one life-prolonging secret to people living in Hunza. We enjoyed drinking directly from a glacial stream flowing off of Mount Rakaposhi during the drive from Gilgit town to Hunza Valley the day before. The water glitters like crystal, is of course icy cold and very refreshing. 10 a.m. in the morning. Snacks of apples or dried fruit.
Apples are probably the most famous produce from Hunza Valley, and you can see orchards reaching up the mountain sides in all directions. They have many different varieties.
If you see an apple tree, try eating one while it's still attached to the stem. Not only are the apples very inexpensive here, a local friend even jokingly cautioned me on how they are so good that you might even be in danger of not wanting an apple anywhere else again. Make sure to try the locally grown almonds, walnuts, apricots and grapes. Dried fruits are sold everywhere in local shops and are a big part of the sales at the local Karimabad market. 11 a.m. in the morning. Boat ride on Akhtabad Lake. Before lunch, you have a decision to make. If you have your own transportation or have access to a rental vehicle, I would recommend the short trip to Akhtabad Lake, one of the truly majestic attractions near Hunza Valley. if not then simply ending a nice spot to soak up more of the valley's stunning scenery is never a bad way to prepare yourself for lunch. The stunning beauty of Attabad Lake, sometimes Atta Abad, is the result of a massive landslide in 2010. Surrounding the lake on all sides are towering steely grey rock faces, examples of the starkness of the Karakoram mountain range. The lake surface reflects a color of the most vibrant blue I can imagine. There is a wonderful restaurant next to a roadside viewpoint above the lake. Stop here for a cup of steaming milk tea and enjoy the panoramic lake view. Finally, if you walk down to the lake's side itself, there are boats waiting to take you for a 15 to 30 minute trip around the lake. 2 p.m. in the afternoon. Have a hearty Hansa lunch. I recommend eating at Hansa Food Pavilion, where the amazing auntie makes completely authentic local Hansa Valley dishes, all the cooking done in-house and done fresh. It is usually run by two ladies who don't start cooking until you order, so you know that every dish is fresh. The aunties are quick to tell you their food is all organic. The cooking here is full of authentic local Hansa flavor. Scroll down to learn about a few examples of local Hansa food you can try when you visit. Daudu noodle soup. Hand-cut noodles made from local wheat daudu is usually made with minced chicken meat. Adding a few slices of onion and cilantro seasoning with cardamom and cumin, the soup itself a golden buttery broth. Daudu is one of the foods you have to try during your day in the Hansa Valley. I think Hansa Food Pavilion served the best single bowl of it out of all the versions we had. The bowl of daudu they serve here is incredibly warming. The gently spiced minced meat smells wonderful in. I love how the broth is so buttery and creamy without being heavy. Chapshurop meat pies. Common to find it full of minced beef. Actually, the traditional chapshuro recipe uses spiced yak meat. The seasoning is simple with a few additions of chopped onions, red chilies, small local tomatoes and coriander leaves. This dish is a wonderful example of the blending of local ingredients with cooking styles common to central Pakistan. The piping hot, very filling chapshuro meat pies are one of the most widely available, but wonderful, dishes you'll find in the Hansa Valley. Altit Fort. If you did not visit the Attabad Lake, then you might have some free time to visit the Altit Fort before your climb to the Eagle's Nest. Don't wait too long though, because you don't want to miss the incredible view of the sun going down over the valley. Altit Fort lies part way up the climb to the area called Eagle's Nest. The original fort structure of the Hansa Valley, built in 1100 AD, the seat of the kingdom which moved to the Baltut Fort a few hundred years later. If you have to choose, then I would recommend the Baltut simply because it's larger and has a better view, but both are full of history of the Hansa Valley and its ancient kingdoms. Cafe the Hansa.
If you're like me, then in these chilly temperatures you will always be looking for the next something warm to drink. Coffee is only recently popular in Pakistan, but due to the amount of foreign too.
Usually on their way to a trek in the Karakoram mountain.
Coffee is available at many places in the Hansa Valley, serving both local and European style snacks to have with coffee. The walnut cake at Cafe the Hansa is great.
Also try the local herbal tea with ingredients native to the nearby Pamir Plateau. 5 p.m. in the evening. Eagle's Nest for sunset. This is one of those views that you will probably remember for the rest of your life and one of the top things to do in Hansa Valley. Climbing up to the Eagle's Nest really takes some effort, but the view is breathtaking. For me, it was one of the highlights of the entire trip. This is something you should not miss on your day in the Hansa Valley. Note:
it can get dark very rapidly up here. There are security guards walking around with torches, but still be sure to watch where you are going, as there are several winding and unmarked paths on which to
get lost. 8 p.m. in the night. Authentic food in Hansa Valley.
There is no better way to experience the authentic local culture in the Hansa Valley than sharing a meal with a local family. Expect rounds of tea and after-dinner snacks to stretch well into the night.
And this actually too turned out to be one of my favorite memories from this entire incredible Pakistan trip. I won't go into all the dishes, but an amazing meal with a heartwarming welcome is how I can put it most briefly. Having the chance to eat local Hansa food with an amazing community of people is such a privilege, and it turns out to be possibly even greater. Extra rounds. Nightlife in the Hansa Valley. If going out and sampling the local nightlife interests you, there are actually a few places in the central streets of Karimabad staying open until midnight or later. I do highly recommend taking a few minutes to walk outside in the crisp mountain air. The air is so clean and so thin you can enjoy some of the most wonderful stargazing you'll ever see anywhere. The high altitude, low humidity and distance from any major city mean that the light pollution here is extremely low.
Find a dark place, give your eyes time to adjust and let the amount of stars visible in the Hunza Valley night sky add a whole new dimension to this magical place.